In this video, I show you how to fade into a vignette in Shotcut just like this. Hi guys, my name is Joe, and on this channel, I help content creators just like you use open source software. This video has been inspired from a recent subscriber, Alswords, who asked, could you do one on a circular reveals from the center with a vignette edge? And my answer to you, Alswords, is yes, absolutely, we certainly can. And if anybody else is having trouble performing specific actions in Shotcut, then just let me know and I'll try to help answer as many questions as possible. There's also a fantastic group of people in the Shotcut forums, so I suggest posting your question there if you're stuck. And I'll leave a link in the description below if anyone's interested in joining the forums. So let's jump into it. I'm sure some of you have just seen the finished effect and are thinking, what's a vignette? It isn't overly apparent when you first start video editing and is made to be subtle. So let me demonstrate. If we take a look at an image with a vignette and then without, you can see that the edges of the image are darkened in a circular fashion. This is what's called a vignette and encourages the viewer to look at the center of the screen. It's used a lot in production videos and indicates there's nothing going on around the edges of the scene and your focus should be on the subject in the center. You can apply this same effect in Shotcut, and more specifically, what Alswords was asking is, can you have a vignette, which is a filter, into a fade, which is a transition, whilst using keyframes to modify the filter? It sounds extremely complex, it really isn't. Let's jump over to the computer so I can show you how we create this effect in Shotcut. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is show you that there's two ways to apply this transition. So to start off with, this first method is quite simple. I've started off with a new project and I've added two items to the playlist. They're both images in my case, but this will work exactly the same with video clips. So drag the first one in and then drag the second one in. Close any gap that you might have so they're butting up to each other, and then select the first one and come up to filters, click on the plus and then search for vignette on the video filter. Click onto vignette, and as you can see, this black kind of effect in the corners applies instantly. I'll go over all of these settings in the second method, but for now I'm going to leave them as default. I'm going to come up and copy this filter, and then I'm going to select my second clip and paste, which gives me the exact same vignette effect on both images. I'm now going to drag over on the timeline so I make a transition effect with this egg timer kind of shape. With this selected, I'm going to come up to properties and then select in the video dissolve. I'm going to change that to iris circle. When I play that, you get this effect. As you can see, the vignette stays in place on both images whilst the transition happens from the very center of the video. This is the most basic way, but also I would suggest it's the preferred way to do any transition of this type. Now that's quite a basic transition and using basic tools to create that. I know it's not quite what Alswords was asking, so let's address his exact requirements in the next method. Okay, so I have started a new project in Shotcut and now I'm ready to add some media into the playlist. I'm going to file and just select four images. You can use videos. I'm using images just because that's what I've got available, but this works exactly the same for images or video. So now I'm going to drag the first one to the timeline and add the vignette filter. To do that, come up to filters, go to the plus and search for vignette. Click onto vignette and you can instantly see that the black around the edges has been applied. Now you can play around with these settings. I'm going to change mine just slightly because I think that's, for me, too harsh an edge. So I'm going to add some feathering, which will make that a little bit more blurry. And then I'm going to take off
the non-linear feathering, which makes it look a lot smoother in its transition. You can apply these as you need, but mine, I've got as radius as 50, feathering as 500, and opacity as 100 with non-linear feathering turned off. Now, this is what's called a static vignette. It's the most common vignette to apply. It doesn't move or change for the duration of the clip, and it works well with jump cuts, which are the most common type of cut to perform in video editing. If you're feeling confused by the word jump cut, then check out my video on jump cuts and that should clear everything up for you. I'll leave a link in the description below. So now the vignette is applied, that might be all you need. However, Alswords was asking, the vignette circle would bleed off each image, hold the next image for a couple of seconds, then that image would start the reveal from its center. So he wants to start with a blank screen, from the center reveal the image, keep the vignette applied, then do the same again for the next image, but instead of fading from black, fade in from the previous image. Well, there's a few ways we can do this, but I'm going to show you the easiest way, which is also the tidiest and quickest. The first thing we want to do is apply a keyframe to start at 0% and grow to whatever you've got your radius as. In my case, it's 50%. So to enable keyframes on the radius, click here. Now I'm going to come down to the keyframe timeline and I'm going to find 1 second on this part of the timeline. Okay, this indicates that my transition and the vignette speed is going to be 1 second. I'm going to add a keyframe. As you can see, it goes red. And then I'm going to select the original keyframe and drag it down to zero. What that's doing is it's starting at zero and it's transitioning for me over 1 second to exactly where I want it to be at the end of the transition. Let me play that so you can see it. Okay, so now you can see that the vignette never disappears, but it starts with 0% and then grows to the 50% vignette radius. I'll play that once more, just so you can see. Starts with a very small reveal, and then over 1 second, it grows to the vignette size. Still got the vignette on there, but is now just going to stay static for the remainder of the clip. So now, go back to the timeline, and let's add the other clips that we want. And now, come onto your original clip, go into your filters, click copy, and then paste that to each of the other clips. You don't need the spaces in here, I'm just keeping them so you can clearly see which one I'm working with, and in a minute we'll get rid of this space to make it much tidier. But now, if you play each clip, you'll have the same effect happening for each one. Okay, so now we're going to bump the two together. I'm just going to remove the space and let's just have a look and see what happens here. So it starts with a very small transition. It goes to the full size vignette, stays static, and then starts again from black, going to the next one. And then if we remove this space here and this space here, it will be doing exactly the same again and again. Now, that is almost what Alswords was asking for. What he actually wants is this one to transition into this one after the first one has been created. So what we do is just simply drag over by the amount of time that you created your keyframe vignette. So for me, that was 1 second. And now when you play, you get your vignette fading in from the start. It will stay static for a couple of seconds. And I've just paused it. But now what's going to happen is the fade and the vignette transition is going to happen all at the same time. It fades to the other image and pulls out to still have the vignette. If we do that for the other images as well, you can now see that each one fades and vignettes at the same time. You might want the vignette fade to be slightly different to what I'm producing here, which is absolutely fine. You can play around with the settings. For example, if I undo and then I fade for more than a second, let's make it 2 seconds, you'll see a different effect occurring, which may be more what you'd like. You could also, if I undo once more, have a much smaller transition, which would then cause a different effect again. Now it's important to realize that a vignette, by definition, is always going to be black on the outside. You can't change that because that's the industry standard and default setting for any vignette. So I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing. Let me know if you have any questions of your own, and I'll do my best to get back to you. Otherwise, have a good time, and I'll see you in the next video.